Well, remember that if we leave the parentheses off of a function name, it simply returns the function object rather than calling that function. Let's see what this looks like in the Chrome console. Setting a debugger for right after our path is created, we can now pause execution and inspect the path object itself. Here we are in our code, right beneath the path object. And if we simply type path without any parentheses, we can see here that a function is actually returned and not called. And if you notice, the path is actually a function that takes a single argument and acts very similar to the accessor callback functions that we've explicitly defined ourselves. In this case, it gets passed the data bound to each element. And to make this a little bit more explicit, let's pass our first GeoJSON country, in this case Afghanistan, to the path itself. As you can see here, we're passing a GeoJSON object to our path function, and what gets spit back is a jumble of strings. In this case, scrolling to the top of this string, we see a strange stream of numbers prefaced by the letter M, separated by commas. This is simply the SVG way to specify which path to draw and which pixels to connect on the screen. Again, D3 being the great library that it is, makes it so you don't have to concern yourself with any of this messiness.